instrumental in actually physically putting together your daughter's timetables for your for year 10. I'd also like to welcome Mrs. Megan Ball, our head of middle school, who you would know, Mrs. Julie Brunkhorst, our dean of students, Mrs. Nairi Hatzmahal, our student counsellor, careers and tertiary entrance, and I did see the head of year 9. She's in the foyer still, helping people come in. So thank you to all of those people who are here this evening, and Mrs. Gail Harris, our head of senior school, will be joining us a little later on as well. Also, a huge welcome, thank you to you, our Year 9 parents, for coming this evening, and especially our Year 9 students who've accompanied as well. And particularly, if any of you, have we got any boarder parents here this evening? Special welcome, very welcome, and even though they will be watching this after the fact, we'd also welcome all of our other Year 9 boarder parents who will be joining us via video, be able to watch the video at a later date. So just a little bit about the format of this evening. I'll be talking to you, I do have quite a bit of information to get through, but I'll try and get through it as quickly and as succinctly as I can, so that you then have an opportunity to go and see people around the room that you have specific questions for. We have our heads of department here this evening, and I very much thank them for making themselves available tonight. So they will be placed around the perimeters of the hall a little later on, so that if you have any subject-specific questions you'd like to ask, you can go and speak to those particular heads of department. Both Nairi Hatzmahal and I will be available at the end, as will all of our other staff, to answer other any general questions you might have. So I'll take about 40 minutes maximum to give you as much information I can in general, and then we're going to move into an opportunity for you to go and ask questions and speak to the individual staff members who might be able to assist you. So, as I've said before, these are the key staff who are here this evening. And in terms of very specific inquiries, Mrs. Hatzmahal will be able to help you with ongoing pathways planning towards tertiary education. I can assist you with any general academic program information. And of course, it's our heads of department who will be able to give you very specific information about subjects. And then girls can contact Ms. Bennett if they have any queries about their online selection. But just to put Year 10 into a little bit of context before we start talking about what subject options your daughters have for 2019. So just looking at Year 10 at the first phase of her secondary education, and looking at the endpoint firstly, by the time your daughter completes Year 12, she will be eligible, or we aim to support her to become eligible to attain her Queensland Certificate of Education, or her QCE. You hear New South Wales and Victoria talking about the VCE and the HSC. Queensland has a QCE, and that is undergone renewed vigour with the new system commencing next year. So that is an important part of your daughter's academic journey. She will be undertaking her QCE in Year 11 and 12, and of course next year is the first most significant step towards that. Also, as an end point to your daughter, as a mechanism to get into university studies post Year 12, will be going through and to receive an ATAR, or Australian Tertiary Admissions Rank. Now, unlike the QCE, is actually overseen by the Queensland Curriculum and Assessment Authority. We work in very closely with them. We're required to follow all of their policies and procedures for their Year 11 and 12 courses. But the ATAR will fall under the oversight of the Queensland Tertiary Admissions Centre. So they're the two organisations that will have some significance for your daughter over the next 3 years. And as I say, year 10 is a quite significant step forward on that journey, because our key focus in the senior school is to continue on that journey that she is currently undertaking, and that is that Australian curriculum that is the focus of all of our middle school programs. So that continues on, but also laying very important foundations for the QCAA subjects that she will be undertaking in year 11 and 12. And of course, as across our entire school, we have a Somerville House curriculum framework, and that really articulates the aspects of learning that we really value the most here at Somerville House, and that guides everything we do in terms of teaching and assessment in all of the courses that we offer. So within that framework and that overall senior education context, in looking more closely at Year 10, these are really what we're aiming to do. In Year 10, we are really aiming to give your daughters a really good opportunity to develop her learning behaviours and develop that academic buoyancy that will really be required for success in later years. It is most important that as they move through the senior school, our students develop that ability to be very independent and resilient learners, and these learning behaviours really help her head in that direction. Year 10 is also an opportunity, particularly for some students, to start specialising in particular learning area a little bit more than she may have the opportunity now. It is important to note, however, that it is wise to keep a bit of breadth in an academic program and a bit of a range of different types of subjects and different types of academic skills that she will be developing throughout Year 10. Just recently, at two separate university events, in speaking with university professors there, their advice is particularly moving into the future and the nature that future work will be in another 25 years or so. I know that's scary to think that far ahead, girls. But having a breadth of skills and having developed expertise across a range of disciplines will be most important for our emerging generations. So it's a really good opportunity in Year 10 to perhaps start specialising in one area, but to make sure that they're still learning across a range of subject areas and disciplines to build in that breadth. Also, academic rigour starts to build in Year 10 in preparation for Year 11 and 12, and of course all the requisite skills that goes with that, so that students are able to manage as successfully as they can all of the assessment requirements in Year 11 and 12. And an important part of that are these students' higher order thinking and problem solving skills, which I'll talk about in a moment. So you are probably, you will be familiar with these. I'll just make this a little bigger. These are the Somerville House learning behaviours. These are those habits of mind and those important intellectual dispositions that are really important to a student to become that independent, resilient learner who's open to new learning, who's able to manage challenges, and who persists at all times in order to further extend themselves and further develop their learning and their thinking. So they still continue to be an important focus in Year 10 and right through Year 11 and 12. And in Year 10, students will still be reported on those key learning behaviours for their different subjects. I mentioned before those key cognitive skills. Now, these are essential skills, and it's probably a little bit small. I'll try and blow it up a little bit. These are those all-important intellectual skills that enable we as human beings to process information, to problem solve. They include the higher order thinking skills, and they are most important for development, not just for our short-term education, but for life in general. And while your daughter has been developing these skills since her education commenced, or her formal education commenced, you will notice that these skills will be embedded much more explicitly throughout the senior school. It is these skills, and this is a list released by the Queensland Curriculum and Assessment Authority, these are the skills that will be strongly embedded in all of the Year 11 and 12 subjects in terms of what students learn and how they are assessed, what they need to demonstrate in their assessment, and of course the marking schemes for that assessment includes these quite clearly as well. So Year 10, regardless of the subjects that your daughter is studying in Year 10, all of the programs have a very strong focus in enabling students to practice and develop these skills as much as possible. So, with that, those learning behaviours and those cognitive skills in our Year 10 programs, they lay the foundations for what your daughters will need for their QCE in Year 11 and 12. And also the assessment that is designed in Year 10 is also designed to set your daughters up so that she is able to meet all the required standards in the Year 11 and 12 assessment, and our Year 10 assessment builds in the requisite skills that she will require. So what happens in Year 10 then? Your daughter's studies themselves in Year 10, or her Year 10 results, will not contribute directly towards her QCE. However, we do start registering students during their Year 10 year with the QCAA and set up an online learning account for her. So at some point during the year next year, she will receive information about her QCAA learning account in readiness for her Year 11 and 12 studies. So let's have a look then at the academic program that your daughter can undertake in Year 10. In conjunction, of course, with our ongoing pastoral program here. So there are some recommended criteria, because even though there is a core component, a mandatory component to the Year 10 academic program, your daughters will have more choice in subjects than they had in Year 9. And so it's important to consider what is the best criteria on which to judge or on which to base their decisions about which subjects they would prefer to continue with in Year 10. And of course, this is the criteria that we advocate. This is the criteria that QCAA and QTAC advocate for students in Year 11 and 12. And that is, yes, students should be heading towards subject areas that they enjoy, that they will be motivated in. Definitely subjects that they have had some success with, so that they can continue to build on those successes in Year 10. And different individuals have different levels of academic strength, and they have different areas of academic strength as well. It's important, as I mentioned before, to keep options open and to keep a range of learning areas going in Year 10 so that they do have more options in Year 11 and 12. There are two aspects to the Year 10 academic program. There is core program and also elective program. Is that okay over there, Ms. Yufana? There's something falling from the ceiling. Hopefully all is well. Goodness, I think somebody's getting into the pipe organ over there. So as part of the core program, there are some core subjects that have less time allocation to them. However, they're still very valuable, important subjects. And students, as part of their core, would also undertake 3 8-session a fortnight core subjects as well. Even though the learning areas are mandatory, students have a little bit of choice in a couple of those, and I'll talk about that in a moment. In addition to that, students are able to elect 3 electives that they would like to study as part of their elective program in Year 10 as well. So looking at that more closely, in a different way as well, working as teams. And so those two subjects will still be included in their program next year as mandatory core subjects. There's also another program that we have for one session a fortnight in Year 10. It's called My Academic Path. We introduced that program this year. Part of that program will include things like managing your senior studies and study skills workshops. We also work with the students in that program to start mapping out their studies throughout Year 12 and throughout Year 11 and 12 and through to tertiary education. So My Academic Path is an important part of the Year 10 program as well. In addition to that, there are 3 8-session fortnight learning areas, one of which is English, and English is a mandatory subject for all students to continue with in Year 10, partly because that's still a core subject for the Australian curriculum, and also it's a very crucial subject for moving forward throughout secondary education and tertiary education. But also, once your daughter does get to QCE, study her QCE, meeting literacy requirements is a mandatory requirement of that, so continuing with English is quite important. Same with mathematics. Students must continue a mathematics subject in Year 10. However, starting from Year 10, there are some options built in there. Students can either elect to undertake Mathematics 1 as their core subject, or Mathematics 2 as their core subject. Now, Mathematics 2 is perhaps more complex in nature, more complexity in its problem solving, perhaps more demanding for students. However, if your daughter is really managing Year 9 mathematics and able to demonstrate that she's able to attain a B standard or above at Year 9 maths, then Mathematics 2 would be a good option for her. If your daughter is wanting to continue through with foundational maths, or she's finding Year 9 mathematics a little bit challenging, or only able to demonstrate a C standard overall in mathematics, then selecting Mathematics 1 would be the best option for her. And later this evening, Mr. Redmond, our head of mathematics, will be available for you if you have any queries about that. And we'll also be speaking with the girls later this week about those options. There's also a couple of options with regard to science. Science also continues to be part of the core program in Year 10. Again, it's a core program in Year 10 for the Australian curriculum. And because it's a fairly common prerequisite for university too, students, it's very wise to keep that going at Year 10 level. However, we have 2 science options here at Somerville House. We have natural science or physical science. So students can elect to take either one of those as their core option. Now you can see from the table there that natural sciences perhaps includes more of a focus on biology, but also on chemistry, as well as some other general science areas. And physical science is a science that has a stronger focus on physics and chemistry. So depending on what direction in the future your daughter might want to head to for sciences in Year 11 and 12, she has the choice of those. A student can elect both if they wish to do both sciences. They can choose natural sciences as their core science, and they can choose physical sciences as one of their 3 elective subjects. So students are able to do both sciences should they wish, but they must do at least one. And again, if your daughter is managing, the student is managing Year 9 science really capably, and they're able to demonstrate a B standard or above, or they're very keen to work towards being able to do physics or chemistry, then it's recommended that they undertake physical sciences. If your daughter wants to opt towards a more general science course, or she's getting a C standard in Year 9 science, then natural science would be a more advisable option for her. And again, we have Mrs. McLean, our head of science, here this evening, and she'll be able to answer any questions you might have a little bit later on. And again, we will be talking to all the Year 9s later in the week about those options. So they are the three core 8-session subject areas, and English, one of the two mathematics options, and everyone has to elect at least one science. In addition to that, students have a range of electives they can choose from. Students only do 6 8-session electives in total, so one of which is science, one of which is a maths, one of which is an English, so that leaves 3 electives. If students want to use one of those electives for another science course, that's fine. So they can choose, as I said before, they can choose natural science as their core and physical science as their elective, or they can just choose physical science as their core. It's up to them, or natural science as their core. The students can elect up to 2 commerce subjects, and we have a combination of different commerce subjects listed there, and that students can have a look at. There's a range of, we have drama, music and art in the arts areas. We have 4 languages going right through our senior school, so your daughter may wish to continue her language on to at least the end of year 10. And I would suggest if she's not sure whether she will continue a language on in year 11 and 12, it's probably wise to keep a language going in year 10, if that's the case. Because if your daughter discontinues a language in year 10, it would be very difficult to take it up again at year 11. Perhaps that's a consideration to take on there. If your daughter may be considering a language in year 11 and 12, it is wise to continue it right through. We also have social sciences, geography and history in that area. And of course we have physical education, we have health and PE continuing. In addition to the core PE, students can choose an 8-session elective for physical education, and that is designed for students who both are interested in sport but also potentially interested in taking our new Year 11 and 12 health subject, which we're introducing next year. So students are able to elect, as I say, 3 of those, and we also ask students to decide upon a reserve subject as well from that list. So where do you find out information about each of those subjects? There is a subject information booklet available to you electronically. The link to that booklet was sent out to you late last week, and I'll show you on a slide in a moment where you can find that booklet in My Somerville under the middle school curriculum area. You'll find the link there. You also have access to the heads of department this evening. We'll be providing students with information on all of those subject options later this week on Thursday and Friday morning. Your daughters also can seek advice and information from their subject teachers as well. So that will be most important. So it doesn't have to be a rushed decision. The whole process takes a couple of weeks, so you don't have to dash home this evening and make a decision this evening and make sure you get your subject preferences in. I would encourage students to wait, to get all the research and information that they can, to seek advice from their teachers, to take a couple of weeks to have good discussions with you about what subject options they would like to undertake in year 10, and they've got plenty of time to put their preferences in. So just for your information, some of the year 10 subjects that really articulate directly to senior subjects are listed there. Though all of these subjects continue straight through into year 11 and 12. And sorry, I neglected to mention before, we also have digital technologies here this evening, and we have a new subject in year 10 called digital solutions and technologies, which leads to digital solutions in Year 11 as well. We also have a range of commerce subjects. We have four commerce subjects: economics, law, which leads towards legal studies, accounting, and business education in Year 10, which leads directly to business, the new subject of business in Year 11 and 12. There are other subjects in Year 10, however, that prepare students for a multiple subjects in Year 11 and 12. For example, history will prepare students for both modern and or ancient history in Year 11 and 12. The natural sciences, as I said before, have a stronger focus on biology and chemistry. Physical sciences have a stronger focus on chemistry and physics. And of course, mathematics will lead students towards the general mathematics course in Year 11 and 12. Mathematics 2, however, will provide students with the options of taking up either general mathematics or mathematical methods in Year 11 as well specialist mathematics. Just for your information, if you're still thinking of the old Maths A, Maths B, Maths C, they're not directly equivalent, but general mathematics is fairly similar to Mathematics A. Mathematical methods would be fairly similar to Mathematics B, and specialist mathematics is the equivalent of, or similar to current Mathematics C. So assessment in Year 10, as I mentioned before, is really, will model for your daughters the assessment formats and the nature of assessment that she will be coming across in Year 11 and 12. There has been a shift in the way assessment is going to be marked in the new QCE system, and for individual assessment tasks, students will be receiving numerical grades. Now, some of our middle school subject areas have already transitioned to that style, and you would be used to that already. So already our mathematics, our technologies, our languages, our sciences have moved towards numerical marking. Our literacy-based subjects are maintaining our criteria A to E-based marking for individual items. However, in Year 10, all subjects will adopt the numerical marking system as similar to what is followed in the new Year 11 and 12 courses that your daughter will be undertaking. So that will be one shift next year. For individual assessment items, your daughter will receive a mark out of, for example, 25 or 20, depending on the total marks for the test. Specific individual marking schemes will be used that the students can see why they've gotten the marks that they've got, what they're demonstrating in their work, and so on. However, overall results in reporting will still be reported on an A+ to E- scale, even though individual assessments will receive a numerical grade. Can your daughter change subjects in Year 10? Yes, she can, providing it's going to work with her timetable and providing there is room available in that course. So your daughter may lock in her preferences in the coming weeks, but then find by the end of the year perhaps something isn't going to be quite the best fit for her, or between now and the start of next year, we'll be able to look at what other options she could undertake if she needs to change some of her subject preferences this year. At the start of every Year 10 year, students have the first 2 weeks of Semester 1 to change a subject if they need to, and if it's possible in their timetable. And again, at the end of Semester 1, in the first week of Semester 2, students are able to make a subject change then if necessary. Year 10 is probably a better time to trial a subject to see if that's going to be the best fit for Year 11 and 12, particularly with the new QCE courses. It is going to be a little more difficult to change subjects during the course of Year 11 and 12. So it's a really good idea to use Year 10 as that year just to make sure what subject areas are going to be the best fit in readiness for Year 11 and 12. But But they can change subjects. It's just a matter of completing the paperwork and getting your approval, and then we actually see if it's going to be possible with her timetable, and they can move across. They do need, however, to move across at the end of semester, not at any point during the course of the semester. The only exception we make to that is some changes may be necessary from one maths to the other after term one. Other than that, students must complete a full semester of study before changing to another subject. Just to let you know, in the senior school, some of your daughters may be eligible for what we currently refer to as special provision. It's going to be referred to as access arrangements and reasonable adjustments in the new system. So that is if students need particular, have particular needs around assessment based on particular cognitive functioning or ongoing illness or short-term illness, those arrangements will still be in place. It will be, however, a more formalised requirement than you may be used to in middle school. If a student is ill, for example, they must have a medical certificate. If they're injured, they must have a medical certificate so that we can reschedule that assessment. We cannot be waiving assessment, particularly as we move up towards year 12. All assessments must be sat or completed. We can, however, make some adjustments to those assessments, providing there is the relevant documentation, etc., to go with their access arrangements. So just letting you know that that will continue through year 11 and 12. If you have any questions about that, Mrs. Bronkhorst-Dorai can assist you there. It is a more formalised process in senior school. Also, reporting will continue in year 10. You will receive twice yearly reporting with an interim report around the end of term one. And similarly to current reporting, your daughter will be able to receive some feedback, not only about her levels of achievement, which will be reported on an A plus to E minus scale, but also how she's travelling with those important learning behaviours and some feedback around her key strengths, areas of consolidation, etc. So that will continue. Just very quickly, because I've got only got about 5 minutes left, talking about submitting subject preferences, which you will do online, and some of you may remember that you may have had to do this last year when you were selecting some of the year 9 subjects, but every student has a leaflet with their individualised login in it. They were available out in the foyer. So if you haven't picked yours up, can I please encourage you to do so before the end of the evening? If you happen to misplace that, if the dog eats it or your daughter loses it in some way, please don't panic. If you lose your login information over the next few weeks, if you contact the curriculum office, they'll be able to provide you with that login information again. Subject submissions are open as of today, and they will close on Friday the 31st of August. And as I said, that's to give you a couple of weeks to look at the subject information, for your daughters to have some good conversations with her teachers and with yourself before making the final decisions. It's definitely not first in, first served, so please be assured that you have time to make those decisions carefully with your daughter. Now, apart from the website link, which is indicated on your login sheet, on my Summable, and I'll just make this a little bigger so you can see. On my Summable, in the middle school curriculum page, you'll notice some links over here on the right. The top one is the link to the web preferences where you can put your subject selections in. The second one is actually the subject information booklet that gives you all of the information about the year 10 courses, subjects, assessments and so on. And also after tomorrow, this evening's presentation, a copy of this evening's presentation will go up there as well. So you'll be able to access all of that information. When you do get into your web preferences, as you can see here, you use the log- login information that was provided on your individualised sheet there, and to actually start logging in to the Web Preferences website, your page will look something like this. There is a green button. Again, I'll make it a little bit bigger. Please click the green button that says Add New Preferences. And then that will take you through to where you can start selecting your options for your year 10. You will note that English is not listed there. That's because English will automatically be added to every student's academic program. However, there are your maths options there where you can select your preference for either Mathematics 1 or Mathematics 2. There is your science options there where you can select either natural sciences or physical sciences. And then your three electives plus a reserve down the bottom. And as I said, you can choose the second science as one of your electives. You can't, by the way, choose the same science twice, girls. It's being two different ones. Well, once you've done that, you do need to click that, you do need to make sure you click the Receive button to register your preferences. And then it will list what you have selected. It has a list what you've selected there. If you need to cancel it and start again, you can do that. Please make sure that once you've checked that list, and I'm just making this a little bigger for you, whoops. Once you've checked that your preferences are the ones you wish to submit, you do need to click the green Submit Preferences button. If you don't follow through with that process, it won't actually submit your options for you. Once you've done that, it will come up with a preferences receipt screen. And there is a button there for you to be able to print that out. We do ask you, please, to print that out because we do need parental signature on that. So once you print that out, you can sign it, your daughter can sign it, and you can either then email it to curriculumoffice@Somerville, the email address is in here, or your daughter can just bring the hard copy in and submit it to either, there'll be a box in the middle school office, and there'll be a place they can submit it at the curriculum office in A Block as well. But we do need that signed form to verify that they are the preferences that you have approved as parents. So it is a pretty straightforward process, and if you need any assistance with that, our curriculum office staff will be more than happy to assist you in that. So just very quickly to finish that off before we move on to other questions, sorry, making people seasick here. Just a reminder about those key criteria for choosing subjects. Subjects that you enjoy, subjects that you have some success with, subjects that are going to leave your options open for year 11 and 12 and beyond. We're going to move now to different areas of the hall should you have any specific questions. And apologies, there's probably more chairs out this evening than there would be normally. So the heads of department are going to be based around the perimeters of their hall, near their subject banners. I think maths are going to move further around here so there's a bit more space. And Monsieur Fourneau, if I could ask you to move the languages around a little bit too, so that we're spread about a bit. Mrs. Hatzmahau for Pathways and Study Planning Advance will be near the senior school sign. I'll be over here near the curriculum sign. Our heads of department will be based around the hall. Please ask any questions that you have for us this evening. And so